second-round draft pick from Michigan. Look at the Bears in their black shoes, Tommy. You talk about all-time football. Anthony Thomas motors outside at Cincinnati for 46 yards. First and goal, the Bears. Next play, Jim Miller to Fred Baxter. He rustles into the end zone, 1 yard, 10-0 Chicago for Dick Jeron. Now, last week, Corey Dillon had 140 yards, but against Brian Urlacher and the Bears' defense, different story.
Yeah, you watch Urlacher work the middle along with the two big guys inside, Keith Traylor and Ted Washington, and they have virtually eliminated the inside run game for football teams. Here you see Corey Dillon getting stacked up time after time, trying to either run the ball inside just off the tackle or cut the ball back inside. Here he tries to bounce out, and again, the defense is able to catch up with him. So strong defense inside and speed enough to get outside like Dick Butkus.
Like Dick Butkus, the monsters of the Midway. Bears up 10-0. Marcus Robinson knee buckles, tackled by Brian Simmons and Darrell Williams. Robinson out of the game with a left knee sprain, so that's better than it looked. Bears up 10-0 late second. Thomas up the middle. Bears trying to get more score before it's halftime. First and 10, Thomas. I mean, it's pretty basic formula, actually. It's what the Bengals would have preferred to do with Corey Dillon. This is a little pitch from the outside. Bears executing and doing it with confidence, Tom. 8 yard pickup, 110 in the first half for Thomas. But they didn't score in that series. So, Bears up 10-0 third. Miller, David Terrell, number one draft pick, wide receiver, 41 yards, setting up a TD catch from Miller to Marty Booker, 17-0 Bears. So you're pitching a shutout, and you're running the ball. I'd say running it, Anthony Thomas, 22 carries, 188 yards, touchdown Chicago. The longest winning streak since 95. Their first shutout since 93. The Chicago Bears have a defense and maybe have a first place team, Tom, if Green Bay would lose.